This is KNEB.TV weather from the KNEB Storm Center, your trusted source for weather.
Well, pretty quiet here across the region as we have mostly cloudy skies early. We'll decrease in those clouds later on. And temps that are going to stay up there, we've warmed up behind that Arctic air that's been pushed off to the north and east. The Chinook winds finally warmed us up today. Quiet weather is coming. Could see a few flurries or snow showers around tomorrow. Otherwise, moderating temps that'll in fact be above normal by the middle portions of next week. 15 was all for our high yesterday. Our normal low is 14. So well below normal for this time of year. Normal high 41. As we look across the area, another 5/100ths of an inch of moisture. We're up to 44/100ths now in Scott's Bluff. That's about 3 to 4 times what we would ordinarily have, a little over 4 times we'd ordinarily have this time of year. Here is the radar loop, and you can see this thing, this is over 2 days of radar loops here. That is quite a bit of time. We're going to put that in loop one more time for you. This is the snow you could see over the course of 2 days, and it really filled in the same general vicinity, and that's what caused a lot of this snow in the same area. And again, the heavier snow bands right along this vicinity, and that's where we saw the most snow out of this storm system. Here is a look at current temperatures. You can see 30s out there as well for most of us, 20s and 30s. This cold air that's off to the north has been shoved out and moved away from us behind that boundary, and you can see it has moved well to the north and east of us. We finally got temps above freezing back here for most of us. Winds are a little gusty out of the south-southwest. That's the Chinook effect helping warm those temperatures up. Also blowing some of that snow around, some gusts around 30, dropping those wind chills into the teens and 20s for the most part. All in all, though, a much better day today than where we were yesterday. We still have high wind warnings out in the high country, and those wind-prone areas of eastern Wyoming, those aren't going anywhere. And in fact, they're going to extend through tomorrow. As you could see, areas from Laramie up through Wheatland, Cheyenne, anywhere along that I-25 drive, that's the area that we're most. So again, if you're traveling those areas from Cheyenne up through Chugwater, Wheatland, Douglas, high wind warnings continue through tomorrow as those winds are just not going to decrease there in the high country. A few clouds, maybe even some fog in a few areas tonight. Otherwise, we're going to clear off as we go through the evening hours into the early morning hours tomorrow, but our temps are going to stay up. Mostly in the 20s overnight for lows. A few areas may not even get out down into the 20s, and a little cooler right around the Ogallala, Oshkosh area, still down into the teens. Now tomorrow, we have a bank of clouds through here. Now during the day tomorrow, we're going to see a brief period of time where some snow showers are going to move across the area. Could see even some light accumulations, mainly in the central and eastern portions of the panhandle, I think is where most of that activity is going to go. And we're going to look for high temperatures tomorrow in the 40-degree range, a few upper 30s out there as well. So right along that system is where any of the precip is going to come, and it's going to come in the form of some snow, light snow for the most part. Everybody should be under an inch, maybe an inch or two at most, and it's going to be fairly hit or miss. Some areas won't pick up hardly any at all. As we go across the area tonight, we'll call it clouds decreasing, 28 for a low. Tomorrow, it's going to be partly cloudy. A few snow showers can't be ruled out. About 40 for a high. And we're going to stay a little cooler on Sunday near 40 again. Then we warm up by Monday, then especially Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, back into the mid and upper 40s. That puts us above normal just in time for another system to arrive for next weekend with breezy conditions and temps falling back into the 30s by Friday.